Welcome to LMS Power Electronics Lab class. So today I'm going to explain about experiment number 5 in the 5th semester Power Electronics Lab. The subject code is 15EE55P. So the title of the experiment is RC triggering circuit. RC stands for resistance and capacitance triggering circuits, and this is experiment number 5 in power electronics lab practical. So aim of this experiment is to trigger the SCR using RC firing circuit and determine the maximum firing angle. So as we know, SCR is having 4 layers and 3 junctions, and it has got 3 terminals, that is anode, cathode and gate. So this is the layer diagram of SCR. And the symbolic representation of the device is here I am showing, that is anode A, that is K cathode, and G gate. So basically SCR is a unidirectional device, and once the device starts conducting, the current starts flowing from anode to cathode. So what is triggering in SCR? Triggering means turning on of a device from its off state. So this is one of the terminology that we are using to turn on in SCR. Triggering, or another name is firing also. Sometimes firing of SCR also they will call. So turning on of a thyristor refers to thyristor triggering. Thyristor is turned on by increasing the anode current flowing through it. The increase in anode current can be achieved by many ways. So these are the different turn on methods. First is forward voltage triggering, second is temperature triggering, third dB by dt triggering, fourth light triggering, and fifth is gate triggering. Like this, the different methods are there to turn on the SCR. And among these 5, the most common and efficient method to turn on the SCR is gate turn on method. Okay, by giving a positive current to the gate, we can turn on the SCR, provided it should be in a forward bias condition. That's a very important. So again, in gate turn on methods, we are having R firing circuits, RC firing circuits, as well as a UJT firing circuits. And for our experiment today, I am going to discuss that RC firing circuit. So to conduct this experiment, let us see what are the apparatus required. So it requires a step down transformer from 230 volt to 9 volt and 500 milliamperes of current, SCR, the number TYN 6041 quantity, wire wound resistors 250 ohms, bar 10 watts, potentiometer 1 mega ohm, ceramic capacitor 0.1 microfarad, diode BY127, 2 diodes we required, and kit or breadboard. If you have kit, then it's well and good, and you can also try with this component in breadboard also. Single strand wires lump sum, and CRO with the probes 1 quantity. So let us discuss first the circuit diagram. See here, this is the source that we are using to feed to the supply as well as the SCR, and here we are using the 2 diodes, diode D1 as well as a D2, and 1 variable resistor as we are just listed out in our apparatus requirement, and a capacitor. and this is a load. Load, you can use a ceramic resistor, or else you can also use a 60 watt lamp also here as a load. So the same supply we are giving to both gate as well as the across the SCR, that is anode to cathode. So what happens, the supply is AC here. When we give AC supply during the negative half cycle, this capacitor is going to charge, right? So the lower plate is becomes positive and upper plate is become negative, because in the negative half cycle this terminal becomes negative and this terminal becomes positive. Hence, in the same direction the capacitor is going to charge. So once capacitor like this, through this capacitor diode D2, the circuit is going to complete, and hence the capacitor is going to charge in the during a negative half cycle of the AC supply. And as we know, during the negative half cycle, as the anode terminal is becomes negative, that is why this SCR is in off state. So SCR is not going to conduct in the negative half cycle, and only this capacitor is going to charge with lower plate positive and upper plate negative through this diode D2. So as after the negative completion of the negative half cycle, as the positive half cycle comes, now the capacitor is changed its direction and it's going to charge in the positive direction. Once this capacitor voltage in the positive direction reaches to the VGT, that is a VGT is nothing but gate trigger voltage, VGT, then as this in the positive half cycle, this SCR is already in forward bias condition, and as soon as this capacitor voltage reaches to the VGT, that is threshold voltage of the SCR, then through this diode D1, the current is applied to the gate of a SCR and SCR starts triggering in the positive half cycle. So this is how the RC triggering circuit is going to work. The rate of capacitor here is going to be determined by the value of this R, since this is a variable resistor, and by changing the value of R, we can change the rate of charging as well as the discharging of the capacitors. See, these are the waveforms that we are going to get. As I said, this is a negative half cycle of a AC supply, and during this negative half cycle, the capacitor, this is a dotted line, is showing a capacitor voltage is going to charge in the negative half cycle. And when the positive half cycle comes, the direction of the capacitor is also going to change. So this horizontal dotted line with this, this is the VGT. As we know that VGT is nothing but a threshold voltage of SCR. So once the capacitor voltage reaches to this threshold voltage, then the SCR is going to turn on at this instant, right? At this instant, and hence we are getting this much of output voltage. This is a V naught, and our firing angle is from zero to up to alpha. This is the firing angle. So during this interval, the SCR is in off position, and SCR is going to turn on only at this instant, because the capacitor voltage is reaches to the VGT only at this instant. That is why at this instant only the SCR triggers, and this much of output voltage we are getting across the load, right? So once the supply voltage reaches to the pi value here, then again with the natural commutation, the SCR is going to turn off in the negative half cycle, because it becomes reverse bias. So again the capacitor is going to charge in the next negative half cycle. This same continues. Okay, so these type of waveforms you are getting for high value of resistance, right? So if the value of resistance is high, here the value of resistance is high, then capacitor VC, that is voltage across the capacitor or capacitor voltage, takes more time to reach that VGT. So that is why the firing angle is more. If the firing angle is more, then obviously the output voltage is less. That's what we are seeing here. So these are the waveforms we are getting for high value of R. Similarly, we can draw the value of waveforms for low value of R. So in this case, if we make if we vary the select the resistance R small value, then the capacitor will take very little time to reach to the VGT. So at this interval it is reaching the VGT. Hence the SCR is going to fire at this interval, and this much of output voltage you are getting when the value of R is resistance is low, right? And similarly, in the negative half cycle, as we know, SCR is in reverse bias, hence it is in off state. Again, in the next half cycle, the capacitor is going to charge the same, and again when it will reach to the VGT, then again SCR is going to conduct or trigger in the positive half cycle only. So this is the output voltage. So we know that if the firing angle is less, the output voltage is more. If the firing angle is more, then output voltage is less. And these are the waveforms that we are getting across the thyristor, across the SCR, right? So from this interval to this interval, the SCR is in off position. So whatever the supply voltage is there, the whole supply voltage is going to appear across the SCR, right? And SCR is going to fire at this interval only. So once the SCR fires, then voltage across SCR is going to be very low, that is almost zero. That's what we are showing here, and it will be more clear in this waveforms, right? So from this interval to this interval, the SCR is in off, and whatever the supply voltage, that will appear across the SCR. So once the SCR is fired at this instant, then SCR across the SCR, the voltage is almost zero. And again, in the negative half cycle, the SCR is going to turn off by natural commutation, and across the SCR, you will going to get the whole supply voltage. So here we can take the readings in the tabular column for peak voltage, Vm in volts, instantaneous voltage, V in volts, firing angle can be calculated by alpha is equal to sine inverse V by Vm, and conduction angle is nothing but it is a 180 degree minus alpha, and T on time also we can calculate in milliseconds. So procedure for this experiment is, connections are made as per the circuit diagram. Adjust the potentiometer for maximum resistance and then switch on the supply. So vary the pot in steps and record T on, instantaneous voltage and peak voltage across the SCR using CRO, and record the same in the tabular column. Next point, determine the firing angle and conduction angle for each reading in the tabular column by using the formulae as just now I seen in tabular column, that is alpha is equal to sine inverse of V by Vm, that is a firing angle, and conduction angle is beta is equals to 180 degree minus alpha. So determine the maximum firing angle that can be obtained from RC firing circuit by varying the value of resistance. We can determine the maximum firing angle, and last, that is bring back to the bring back the potentiometer to its original position and switch off the supply. So this is the complete procedure of the experiment. Now what we conclude from this experiment is, if R value is more, then time taken for capacitor voltage to reach VGT, that is threshold voltage, is more and firing angle is more. Therefore, average output is low. If R is less, then firing angle is low and therefore average output voltage is more. From this experiment, just I have set certain multiple choice questions. Let us see one by one. First question is, in case of RC half wave trigger circuit, the firing angle can be ideally varied between, options are A, 0 to 180 degree, B, 0 to 90 degree, C, 0 to 120 degree, D, 0 to 360 degree. So we know that in R and RC triggering circuit, the difference between resistance and resistance capacitance triggering circuit is the variation in the firing angle. So in R firing circuit, the firing angle can be get from 0 to 90 degree. The firing angle can be varied from 0 to 90 degree. Whereas in case of RC triggering circuit, the firing angle can be varied from 0 to 180 degree. So the answer is A, that is 0 to 180 degree. Next, question number 2. If firing angle in an SCR circuit is increased, the output voltage is, options are A remains the same, B is increased, C is decreased, and D none of the above. So just now we have discussed in conclusion that as the firing angle is increased, obviously the output voltage is going to be decreased. So answer is C, that is decreased. Next, question number 3. In half wave RC firing circuit, the SCR A, forced commutated at omega t is equal to pi, B, forced commutated at omega t is equal to 2 pi, C, naturally commutated at omega t is equals to pi, and D, naturally commutated at omega t is equal to 2 pi. So as the supply voltage is AC, and in AC supply the SCR is going to commutated by natural commutation. So the answer is C, that is naturally commutated at omega t is equals to pi. Question number 4. During negative half cycle of supply voltage, the capacitor C, options are A, charges through D2 with lower plate negative, B, charges through D1 with lower plate negative, C, charges through D2 with lower plate positive, and D, charges through D1 with lower plate positive. So as we have discussed in the circuit diagram, during the negative half cycle of AC supply, the capacitor is going to charge, and the lower plate of the capacitor is positive and it is going to charge through diode D2. So answer is C, that is charges through D2 with lower plate positive. Next, question number 6. If the RC firing circuit used for firing an SCR is to be used to fire a triac, then options are A, the capacitor should be removed, B, the diode should be replaced by a diac, C, the diac should be replaced by a BJT, and D, the diode should be shorted using a resistor. So the question is here, in place of SCR in RC firing circuit, a triac is used, then what are the changes we have to make? See, as we know, the triac is a bidirectional device and its gate, it can be triggered by giving positive or negative voltage to the gate. So instead of a diode in the gate of a triac, we can connect a diac, because diac is a bidirectional device. So answer is B, that is the diode should be replaced by a diac. As here I have written the explanation, the triac is a bidirectional SCR, hence it will need gating in both the directions. So this can be achieved by replacing a diode by a diac, because diac is also bidirectional diode. Next, question number 7. In RC firing circuit, if R value is less, the firing angle is low and therefore average output voltage is more. Right? So we know that if R value is less, the firing angle is less and hence we will get more output voltage. So that is why this statement is true. That is, answer is A, true. In RC half-wave firing circuit, diode D1 prevents the negative voltage between the gate and cathode during the positive half cycle of the input through diode D2. In RC half-wave firing circuit, the diode D1 prevents the negative voltage between the gate and cathode during the positive half cycle of the input through diode D2. So this is a false statement. The RC, in RC half-wave firing circuit, the diode D1 actually prevents the negative voltage between the gate and cathode, but it is not through the diode, it is through the capacitor. Okay, so this is false statement. Question number 9. RC triggering circuit is preferred over resistance triggering because A, provides a large value of the triggering angle, B, provides accurate triggering, C, causes quick triggering, and D, protects the device from getting damaged. So just now we have discussed in resistance triggering circuits, that is in R triggering circuits, the maximum firing angle you can vary between 0 to 90 degree, whereas in case of RC triggering circuit, the maximum firing angle can be obtained. So answer is A, that is, it provides large value of the triggering angle. Next, last question is 10th, that is, when capacitor voltage reaches threshold voltage of SCR, when the capacitor voltage reaches threshold voltage of SCR, SCR will turn on and capacitor voltage discharges through D2. When the capacitor voltage reaches threshold voltage of SCR, SCR will turn on and capacitor voltage discharges through D2. So answer is true, that is A, true. And in half wave RC triggering circuit with R load and firing angle alpha, the voltage across R load is 0 in half wave RC triggering circuit with R load, a firing angle alpha, the voltage across R load is 0. That is, first one, A, omega t is equal to 0 to alpha and omega t is equal to pi to 2 pi alpha. So during and B, omega t is equal to 0 to alpha and omega t is equal to pi to 2 pi plus alpha and omega t is equals to alpha to 2 pi. So in this case the answer is A, that is first one, because in a half wave RC triggering circuit with R load and firing angle alpha, the voltage across R load is 0 for this interval only. That is, because in this interval the SCR is not fired, so across the load the voltage is 0. That is answer A. So with this we have completed this. Now let us see the experiment.
So this is RC firing circuit kit. Okay, so here it is a variable resistor and two diodes are connected here, D1 and D2, and through this D1 we are giving supply to the gate of a SCR. So this is our SCR and two terminals, anode and cathode. And here I have connected a resistor, that is a load. Okay, so initially this is what the connections we have to make. Now I will turn on the supply and I will start the switch, close the switch. So initially the resistance is very low here. Okay, so here I have to see the waveforms first. That is a supply. This is my AC input. So here I have to see the waveform across the SCR as well as a So this is the voltage across SCR. Now the resistance is very low, very minimum, and because of this the capacitor is charged so early and the firing angle is very less, that means just above the zero. Now I will gradually increase the resistance and you can see the firing angle is also going to increase in the positive half cycle. Right? See, the firing angle is going to increasing. As the firing angle is going to increasing, firing angle is nothing but a delay angle. Okay. See, now it is more than 90 degree. And at the same time, if I see the output voltage waveform, then you can see this much is the output voltage we are getting. Because the SCR is going to fire at this interval or at this instant. See, I further increase the firing angle. Since it is a RC firing circuit and here we can vary the firing angle more than 90 degree. As we know, in R firing circuit the firing angle can be varied between 0 to 90 degree. But here you can vary the firing angle up to 0 to 180 degree. See, the as I increase the firing angle, the average output voltage is also going to be reducing. See, it's almost more than 90 degree. If I see now the voltage across the SCR, then see, you can see the voltage across the SCR. I can go beyond 90 degree in RC firing circuits. it's almost zero. That is a 180 degree. I will gradually reduce the resistance and firing angle is also going to reduce. As the firing angle reduces, then average output voltage also going to increase. See, this is the average output voltage. So this experiment is RC trigger circuit for half wave, right? This is for half wave circuits. Now I can increase the resistance and firing angle is going to increase, because as the resistance value increases, the capacitor will take more time to charge. As I already explained in the theory, if I increase the resistance value, then capacitor will take more time to charge and to reach that threshold voltage of SCR. The time taken by the capacitor voltage to reach the threshold voltage of SCR will be more, hence the triggering angle or firing angle will be more. If firing angle is more, means the output voltage is less. So here we can draw the waveform for one for voltage across SCR and one for voltage across the load or output voltage, right? So these two waveforms we can draw. At the same time, we can see the amplitude, that is a voltage. What is the, see here, it is a 10 volt. I have set for 10 volt, okay. And here you can see the time, that is a 10 milliseconds. For each division, it is a 10 milliseconds. And for each division, it is amplitude, it is a y-axis, it is a amplitude, it is 10 ohms for each division. So 1, 2 and it's a 3, almost 30 volt. 30 volt is the amplitude, that is Vm will get 30 volt. And what is the time axis? So x axis, if the time is, it is almost, it's a 1 division, that is a 10 millisecond is a x-axis time. Okay, now I'll switch off the, open the switch and switch off the supply. This is the completion of the experiment.